In this video, I will work on this BMW E60. This car has a very common problem with the battery. More exactly, if you leave this car overnight, next day you are not able to start it. The owner have already replaced the battery, have checked the battery, everything is okay, and the car have a power consumption. First thing is to do a diagnose. Next step, I will check the usually suspects for this type of car, for this model, and if I don't find nothing, we will go deeper. About the state of the car, leave it like this because it's not yours, it's not mine, and especially it's not for sale. And we will use this car only for a couple of hours to diagnose it, repair it, and to do this video. So enough with talking and let's dive in. To diagnose the car, I use the original iCom with my tablet with Ista installed. The iCom is not connected with cable because it's wirelessly connected with this tablet. To do this, I'm using this router, this mobile router. Next, we'll connect with the car. And to switch on the ignition, power of the climate control. The iCom will stay on the seat or on the armrest or on the dashboard. Never put your iCom down on the floor. Next, I will power up the tablet. From here, I will select the iCom, the head. And next, we let the Ista to finish identify the car, read the errors, and after that we will continue with this. So from here I can see that the Bluetooth module is not responding, the telephone module, and some modules have errors. I'll go to display fault memories, exhaust temperature, glow plug, oxygen sensor, throttle valve, intelligent battery sensor communication, we'll check this, exhaust gas, thermal oil level, power management, closed circuit current violation because of the battery. You can see now we have a very weak battery, 11.5, 11.4 because of this consumption. Smooth running controller, brake lights under voltage or over voltage. Let's see if we have some details here. Power supply, 6.9 volts under voltage because overnight this car will remain without battery. The SGM, the same, under voltage. SZL, no terminal. Courtesy lights, okay. Climate control, water valve, headlights, battery discharge on the light module. Voltage, power window, under voltage, micro power module, coding data error. From here, the only thing that have connection with the power consumption will be the intelligent battery sensor, the IBS. Okay, with that in mind, I will switch off the ignition. Now we need to open the trunk. I have already removed the trunk content because in the trunk I have the battery and couple of suspects for this battery drain. Okay, inside of the trunk, here is the battery. As you can see, the battery safety terminal was detonated, but that is not my problem. That means that this car have been involved in a small or bigger accident. But repeat, this is not my problem, and the intelligent battery sensor is disconnected. This is his plug, this is the sensor. This will be connected here. This is for communication. This is the power supply of the sensor. But with this sensor disconnected, this cannot cause any problem. With this sensor disconnected, now the car will charge this battery like a regular battery. And because of that, this battery won't last too long. The intelligent battery sensor will measure the voltage, the amperage, and the battery temperature for the perfect charging system. So if I didn't find nothing here, we will check another spot. And the next place is here, underneath this tray. Inside of this, I need to have micro power module and parking assist module, but it's not here.
Okay,
so that means that someone moved them from there. Oh yeah, someone moved them from down there, because sometime on the life of this car, that area have been flooded, like most of the BMW 60s, and these modules have been destroyed. And that's why I think I have that error on this module about the configuration, because I don't think it's coded on this car. But from what I see, it's looking very good. Let me see in the plug. No, it's perfect inside of the plug. Let me see inside of the module. No, I don't see any traces of moisture. I can see some water here, but it's not very much, and some accident marks. You can see the water. You can see the water here, and some repairs done correctly. At this point, if I didn't find nothing unusual on this car, I didn't see something evident to me, I will disconnect the battery and I will use a multimeter. I will put a series. I will put a multimeter in series with the battery. Okay. At this point, I didn't find nothing unusual here. Everything seems to be okay. Next step is to disconnect the battery, use a multimeter, and measure the amperage consumption of the car. Okay, so from here I need this multimeter. These cables. I need a 10 millimeter. Here I place the common with the amps. I will set the multimeter on amps. Put it like this. And like this. Disconnect the battery. Now, something like that, one clamp on this terminal and another one on the battery. You can see now the car, it's drawing 7.7 amps. It's too much, but it's normal when you connect the battery, because now this car is awake and active. Next step, I will open the passenger door and I will close it. I will simulate the door is closed. I'll do the same with the trunk. I will close it. And the same with the driver door. Be careful if the car has soft close. Next step is to make sure that the ICOM is connected. We have lights, it's connected. I don't need the ignition to be switched on. Okay, now from Insta, I'll go display fault memory, service functions, body. From the body, I will select voltage supply, active rest state, power down command. I will hit display. I'll hit continue, I'll select yes, I'll hit continue, sending power down command. The power down command was sent. And you can see the modules are going down. And now we have 800 milliamps. It's very, very much. Normally, this car have, all the BMWs have maximum 80 milliamps. Maximum, this car have 800 milliamps. Over 80 milliamps, the car will give you a message error about the battery, and the battery will go down very quickly. Normally, all the BMWs have somewhere around 40 to 60 milliamps power consumption when they are in sleep mode, like now. But there is a but. From this 80 milliamps, I have a difference. 300 milliamps are taken by the ICOM. So I need to disconnect it like so. And we are down to 472. So that means something it's taking power, something is not going down. Okay, my next step, I need this probe to do some checks. And from here, I need this multimeter with its probes. Like so. Okay, now I'm back in the trunk with this multimeter. I will take my lamp. I will take a ground from here. Let's see, we have power on this fuse. Now I'll check which fuse still have power after the relays are disconnected. So to do this, I will use my lamp. So from this row, all the fuses except this one have power. From this row, only the last one. From this row, only these ones. And these are all. So all these fuses without this one and this one. Next step, with this multimeter on voltage, I will put it here. I'll take the two probes. For these probes, on this probe I have very fine tips. Now I will start to check the voltage drop across the fuse. No, I'm not checking if the fuse is blown. I'm checking the voltage drop. This fuse have 0.1. Next one. I need to be very, very careful because sometimes the end of fuses are corroded. This one is the same, 0.1. Okay, 0. Next one. 0, 0, last one, 0. Okay, next one, I said it was this, 0, and this one's from here, 0. You see, I'm moving the probes to make a perfect connection because sometimes they won't do a perfect connection and I will have a fake reading. 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so this is telling me that the consumer is not here, is not deviated from this fuse box. Now I need to check the second fuse box on this car. Normally on BMWs you have three fuse boxes. One in the trunk, one in the car, and another one are the engine control unit underneath the hood. But that one is only for the engine, and that one have only a couple of fuses, five, three, five, depending of the model.
Next step, inside of the car, on most of the BMWs, the old generation, the fuses are inside of the glove box. On the newer generation, it's here or behind the glove box. On mini cars, they can be on the driver's side, on the passenger side, here near the footrest.
Okay, on this particular car, I can remove the back of the glove box. I need to pull this top and this one, something like that. This car is equipped with a CD changer, but it's not a problem. And you can see here the fuses. Again, with my lamp, I will connect it to ground, where I have a good ground here. Here it's perfect. I will check. Yes, I have ground. Now I will check which fuses have power supply. This one, this one, this one. Okay, in the glove box, all the fuses have power. Next step, with the multimeter, the same set on voltage, I will start to measure the voltage drop across the fuses. Again, first fuse, zero. Okay, second fuse, zero, perfect. Zero. 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 Come on, I know you are here. Zero. 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 Two milliamps. I think we have a winner. Let me see. No, I think we have a winner. Again. Zero here. Zero. 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 And the last one. Zero. Okay, so the 50 amps one have a voltage drop of, come on, 2 milliamps. Okay, we have a winner, I think. Next, I will remove the fuse from here, like so. So let's see what number it is. 28, 29, 30. You can see it. It's down there. Good. Back in the trunk, let's see if removing that fuse, we have removed the 400 milliamps. So now I need to wake up the multimeter. Voila! 11 milliamps. This is perfect. So now I have a lead, and it's the fuse F30.
Now I know that the circuit in which that fuse is will discharge the battery. The fuse is not to protect the circuit. The fuses in the car is not to protect the modules. If you have a fuse for your navigation, the fuse is not to protect your navigation. The fuse is to protect the car against the navigation. If the navigation will somehow make short circuit, the fuse will blown to protect the car against that unit. So, take out from your mind the idea if my light have a fuse, my light is protected. No, your light have a fuse for your house to be protected against that light. So now I need to find out what the F30 fuse it's powering, it's supplying. Okay, now I have a message here, a warning message, because the ICOM is disconnected. So I will break the connection. Break the connection again. Okay, I will close this window because I don't longer need it. Next, troubleshooting, text search. Here in the search box, I will select F30. Hit enter. I have a hit. I will select the SSP. This is the wiring diagram, SSP. Display. And I can see here that the fuse F30, it's a 15 amp fuse, it's correct, it's in fuse holder front. The power supply for this fuse is from the fuse holder rear, from a big 200 amps fuse. That means that this fuse will power up a bunch of other fuses. And this fuse is powering up the heating air conditioning system, A11A. I will click here on the name. And it will show me A11A is the climate control unit. So next time when you need a wiring diagram or everything else, ISTA have everything in it. Stop asking me in the comment section down about fuses and modules and wirings, because I don't know them out of the box. I'm not a computer, I'm a human being like you. I'm using this equipment. So now I will need to check out the problem with the climate control. So little by little, I am closing down the circle. Now I need to remove the climate control to see if I will find something obvious and to repair it. If not, I will replace it. To do this, I need to remove this panel. For this, I need some tools. Okay. Now we are back in business. Perfect. I need to disconnect the switches. Like so. And now I can remove this entire piece. For the climate control, I have two screws here. Phillips type of screws. And now this panel have some clips, like so. Perfect. Now I can disconnect the climate control. One plug here, one here, one here. Now I can do a very quick test, the smelling test. It's not smelling burnt. Next, to the bench to disassemble it. Okay. We have a very small T screws here. I think they are, let me see, T6. Okay. That's all. Next step, I have a couple of plastic tabs. Like so. Normally on this part of the board, from what I remember, is nothing to fail. This is only the interface, but this part of the board is the main unit, and that doesn't need any other introduction. Tell me if you see something unusual on this board. You see it? Yeah. And you see, I have found a problem. Why this car will remain without the battery overnight? Because of this blown circuit from here. Now, there is two options. I know. One, to replace the module. The second one, to replace this circuit from here. To replace this circuit from here, I will need the donor module. So, give me 2 seconds. After searching, I have found two boards with that chip on them. I was pretty sure that I have a climate control for an E60 down in that pile, but I don't have it. So, unfortunately, these boards are here because they are damaged. They are from F-series, from the electric tailgate opener, and both of them have this chip damaged. You can see this is the chip. The first pin from the left is missing, it's corroded, it's no longer there. From here, the same, the first chip from the left is not there anymore, is not available at the moment. The same on this board, you can see, this is the chip from here. Both pins from left and right are missing. And from here, the right pin, it's missing. I will be able to use one of these chips because all 4 exterior pins are for power supply and they are connected together inside of the chip. This chip is a dual channel power chip, but on this case I won't do that. If this was my car, maybe I will do it, but for this I won't do that. Instead, I will remove this chip. I will disconnect the valves from the car, from underneath the bonnet, because this chip is controlling the water valves for heating the inside of the cabin. Now, with the chip disconnected and the water valves disconnected, they are in open position. If they are not energized, they are permanently opened. So in this period, it's not a very big deal because it's very cold outside and the owner will have heating inside of the car. But in the summer, the owner will need to replace the climate control with a new one or a used one, but in good condition. And necessarily, we need to replace the water valves, because I told you one of them is in short, and that's why this chip have made kaboom. So now I will remove it, I will reassemble everything back, I will retest the car, and I will give it back to the owner, because he will need to use this car.
To remove the chip, I will use my hot air gun. Okay, like so, I will pull this back. I'll need a helper to keep the board in place. And I will wait my reworking station to rise up the temperature, and I'll remove it. If you want to use some tools that I'm using, please first check the video description, because I have there some details. And if you don't find there what it's interesting you, use the comment section. Perfect. And as I told you,
you can see the exterior pins are together on this big pad from here, because they are the power supply for this chip. These three pins are together, these three pins are together because this is the output, channel 1 and channel 2. This is not used, one is ground, two pins are for controlling the channels, and the other two pins are for the feedback technology. I will clean a little bit of dust. I will take this chip, I'll put it inside of this tape, like so, something like that, because I think I will need to put it here. I want to put it inside of this unit. Maybe someone will want to repair it and he won't know what type of chip was there. Now, there we have it. Perfect. I need to align the two cases. Bellissimo. I need to clean this small blower. This will pull air from inside of the cabin. Here it's a temperature sensor for this climate control to know exactly what temperature it's inside of the cabin. If you have one of this type of car, BMW E60, E90, E65, when you will stay in the car with the ignition off, always you will hear a small buzzing sound from the dashboard. That sound is made by this small fan. If you will remove the climate control and clean this fan, you will grease the shaft, the sound will be very low. And every time you will open the door, close the door, you will move inside of the car, this will be active, because the car will be active, will be alive, will not go in the sleep mode. If you want the car to go in the sleep mode, you need to wait, do not move, do not touch anything, and the car will go in sleep mode in about 30 minutes. But in the first second that you will touch something inside of the car, a button or open a door, the car will be waked up. Something like that. Okay, until here it's perfect. Okay, inside here I will put back the fuse, like so. I will take out my tools and clean a little bit the dust. And I have found this thing from here, you see it? This screw is loose. And if you're going down the road and something start to rattle inside of your dashboard, you will say that this is a junk car. But the junk car was made by someone who worked before in here. This is not from the factory like that. Like so. This is a cable someone have added for auxiliary input. put back all the owner stuff. Better. I didn't remove that, but I have put it back. And now from the trunk, I'll connect back the battery. Like so. I will wake up the multimeter. 6 amps. Okay, no problem. Close this door. Connect back the ICOM. Perfect. And next, from here, I will connect again with the ICOM. I don't need the ignition on, you can see it. It's 0 volts. I will set up the connection. Vehicle management, service functions, power down, it's already there. Display, continue, yes. Sending power down, the power down has been sent. Let's see.
milliamps. It's perfect. And you know why it's perfect? Because I still have connected the ICOM. If I will disconnect the ICOM from the plug, milliamps.
Perfect. That 11 milliamps are the clock from the processors being in standby, waiting to get up. You see, 11 milliamps. If I will open the trunk, bang, I have woken up the car, 6 amps. Perfect. I will clean a little bit this area and I will mount everything back. Call the owner and remove this car from my garage.
Oh, the water valves seems to be brand new. They have been replaced. But I'm thinking that they have been replaced after the climate control have gone bad. Yeah, they're brand new. You can see them. They are shiny. Nice. And this is from that junk, that improvisation. Okay,
I will reconnect again with the car for the last time. This time I will erase all the fault memories, switch off the ignition, switch on the ignition, and after clearing the errors, we have on the engine control the exhaust temperature sensor, glow plug, cylinder 1-2, throttle valve, intelligent battery sensor. I didn't connect it back and I won't work on that now. On the climate control we have water valve left and water valve right. Why is that? Oh, I know, because there is no more chip to control them in the control unit. Okay, and next communication with the no communication with the control with the phone module, the Bluetooth module. Perfect. Now I will set the time. To set the time, I'm using the service function maintenance, CBS reset, CBS reset display. Please wait, I'm waiting. Bang! Nice! Okay, I will exit from this menu and the time and date was set. And at this moment I am finished with this car. Before I'll go, I want to code the MPM, the micro power module. If you remember, the micro power module have an error at the beginning of this video about configuration because it's replaced and is not code. So to see that, I will use ENPA for this car. I will select E60 functional job. I will go in functional job. Okay, I will go to the ident. Let me see, MPM, it's POW, okay, user file info, POW. Here you can see it's replaced, it's from 2014, it's not original to the car. So to code it, it's very very simple. I will use NCS expert file load profile expert man. Okay, I will select the FA from the ACU E60. Okay, CIS, okay. Perfect, I will go back. Next, process ACU. And from here, let me see, where is it? MPM, micro power module. I'll change job, SG coder, execute job, coding active, coding ended. And this is all. Now I can exit from here. Let's see. Call up ACU. ACU test. Okay. No error. Ah, you can see even here. It's from 2014. Production date. Component triggering, delete and relay. Okay, nothing interesting here. And with this, this car is diagnosed, it's not repaired, because to be repaired, we need a brand new climate control. Fortunately for the owner, he will need only the climate control because the electric valves, they were already been replaced. Now, if you've seen it here with proper tools, and by the way, to have proper tools, first you need to learn to respect your tools. And after that, you'll be able to have high quality and proper tools. And with the necessary knowledge, everything is possible. The sky is the limit. It's not necessary and it's not mandatory for you to know absolutely everything. I don't know absolutely everything. Still, I will need to read a lot of stuff when I work on cars. I need the information from the diagnostic equipment to be able to diagnose a car, to be able to repair it. But if you are ambitious, the sky is the limit. So, if you learned something new in this video, or if you already knew everything that I have showed you here, you are amazing and show me by hitting the like button. Thank you for watching these videos. Thank you for being with me. Until next time, stay awesome. Bye now.